As we continue to move forward, the tasks that are consistent with E6 activities in the startup phase, FDA typically is going to require at least 3 investigational sites. We often get the question, can we use an internal site? But you should be aware that BIMO you can get inspected by BIMO if you use your own investigational site. And you should be aware that if you're the principal investigator and you're the owner of the lab, you need to make sure that you have some type of mitigation plan in place so that the data does not become compromised. We often are asked about ex-U.S. studies or using ex-U.S. trial sites. You want to be aware that the population demographics need to be consistent with what's seen in the United States with regard to your intended use, and that the medical practice in that country is consistent with U.S. practices. And that applies to ex-U.S. sites again. So now we have our plan. We know what we're going to do. We have an idea how we're going to proceed. We want to go through the process of site selection and qualification. We want to start calling sites. We want to make sure that they're qualified, that our principal investigators, the site has the ability to do exactly what we want. And you're going to spend a lot of time in this area trying to find investigators that are interested, sites that are capable, because this is really going to become the cornerstone of the success of your trial. So now let's assume that we have our investigational sites. We want to start the investigational site engagement activities. There are 2 critical components to this. That's going to be related to your IRB and as well as the investigator agreement. The IRB submission and approval process is an absolute requirement before you initiate a clinical trial. And that's the responsibility of the principal investigator, and they're responsible for the informed consent. But you as a sponsor, per Part 50.25, you need to ensure that the essential components of the informed consent are there for each one of your investigational sites. So for prospective enrollment, you may need to make sure that the IRB approval and consenting is in place. If you're going to use residual specimens, you may want to review the document that we've highlighted at the bottom and review the informed consent and enforcement discretion that OIR provides for you. The other piece of this is the investigator agreement, which is your legal contract with your investigational sites. So as the lawyers are playing tennis with your investigator agreements, you need to also get the financial disclosure in place with your investigators. This is a legal requirement per Part 54, and the sponsors have to list and disclose any conflicts of interest that your investigators have with you, your company, or your assay. And the clinical investigators are legally required to provide sufficient and accurate information.